Hello dear students, a very good morning to all of you. Dear children, in yesterday's video I have introduced you with the term lattice enthalpy. Okay, so today we will discuss same term in detail. Okay, so today's topic is lattice enthalpy. Lattice enthalpy. So to explain lattice enthalpy, I will use one equation. M positive gaseous, suppose this is a cation which is in a gaseous state, and this is a anion which is also in a gaseous state, and both these ions are reacting with each other and forms MX, which is a ionic crystal. And suppose enthalpy change during this procedure is delta H. Okay, so now what is lattice enthalpy? So lattice enthalpy is the enthalpy change during the formation of one mole of ionic crystal from its constituent ions in gaseous state. Okay, so this is the lattice enthalpy, as lattice enthalpy represented by U. Okay, so we can write delta H equals to minus U here. Why minus U? Because I put minus sign here because minus sign represents the evolution of energy. Okay, so you can also define the lattice enthalpy by following this equation, that the energy evolved during the formation of one mole of ionic crystal from its constituent ions in gaseous state is known as lattice enthalpy. Okay, this is the definition of lattice enthalpy. Now suppose we want to break this one mole of ionic crystal. Okay, then so if we want to break this ionic crystal, in that case we have to provide some energy. Okay, and then it will change into M positive gaseous and X negative gaseous. So in that case the energy needed to break one mole of ionic crystal is numerically equal to the lattice enthalpy. Okay, so we can write delta H equals to plus U here. Why plus U? I put U here because the amount of energy is numerically equal to the lattice enthalpy for this procedure. Okay, and I put positive sign here because in this case we have to provide energy. Okay, in this case energy is absorbed, so that's why I put delta H equals to plus U. Okay, so you can define lattice enthalpy differently according to this equation now, as lattice enthalpy is the energy absorbed during the breakdown of one mole of ionic crystal into its constituent ions in gaseous state. Okay, so this is the different definition of lattice enthalpy. Now we will see the relation between the stability and lattice enthalpy. Okay, so as you can see here that MX, suppose this is a very less stable compound. So if it is a less stable compound, then we have to provide less energy in that case. And if we are providing less energy, means lattice enthalpy in this procedure will be less. And suppose if this is a very stable compound, then in that case we have to provide extra energy. Okay, so in that case the value of lattice enthalpy will be higher. So we can say that lattice enthalpy is directly proportional to stability. So this is the relation between lattice enthalpy and stability. Okay, after that we will discuss the factors on which lattice enthalpy depends. Okay, so next topic is factors on which lattice enthalpy depends. So you must know about the Coulomb's law, okay, which is force of attraction is directly proportional to Q1 Q2 upon R square. Okay, so in chemistry, force of attraction means stability of compound. Okay, as the force of attraction between the ions is greater, then stability is also greater. So you can write stability also, okay, otherwise force of attraction is also fine. And Q1 Q2 is the charge of cation and anion. Okay, and here R is the internuclear distance between the ions. Okay, so on the basis of this formula, we can say that lattice enthalpy depends on two factors. First is charge on ion, and second is size of ions. Okay, so charge on ion, as you can see from this equation, ki force of attraction is directly proportional to Q1, Q2. So if the charge on ion is greater, then definitely lattice enthalpy will be higher. Okay, as force of attraction means stability, and stability is directly proportional to lattice enthalpy. So we can say that if Q1, Q2 is higher, then lattice enthalpy will also higher. Now, if we talk about the size of ion, so size of ion means suppose we are using smaller ions, okay. So in smaller ions, internuclear distance will be lower. Okay, and if internuclear distance will be lower means the value of R is lower, and value of R is lower means force of attraction will be greater, and force of attraction is greater means lattice enthalpy greater. So for smaller ion, lattice enthalpy will be greater, and oppositely, if you will use large ion, then definitely the internuclear distance will be larger. Then the value of R will be larger. Value of R will be larger means force of attraction will be lower, as force of attraction is inversely proportional to R. Okay, and ultimately lattice enthalpy will also lower. Okay, so these are the two factors on which lattice enthalpy depends. Thank you.